tent. Oh, and just like the river, I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come.
There's so much that we need to do, and we're definitely gonna need the support of the community to do it. Because not only are we bringing services to the community, but we're also bringing employment opportunities back into the community. I'm so conscious now of making sure that even when I shop, to make sure that I'm shopping back in the community. There was nothing for me, oh, I'm going into the city. I'm going here, I'm going there. But what about the business? And then when you wonder why you don't have stores in your community, it's because you don't shop in the store.
It's not just about making money and learning about stocks and bonds and investing money and trying to be like a millionaire. It's really about being a responsible citizen and being somebody who has an impact in your community.
If we walk with love, we're able to bring life into our community, into our families, into our children, breathe life into the relationship that we have with God. And again, we can't leave that part out, because this is the part that's causing the disparity of income that's going on in our society right now. This is the part that's causing the middle class to shrink and dissipate. This is the part that's causing the rich to get richer and the poor to go to prison. It can be fixed if all we do is just add a little bit of love. And we can turn it around. It's easy to turn around. So it is really loving whenever you sit down and you budget and you take your money and your finances and say, I'm going to take the time to budget responsibly, to raise my FICO score above 750, to make sure that my family is adequately covered by insurance, to make sure that I have enough estate, my will, my living will, healthcare proxy, durable spending, financial power of attorney, to make sure that I read the 2009 Card Act legislation so I know exactly how these folks are trying to gouge in my pocket and I can use credit cards responsibly, organize all of them, to make sure that I read the benefits book for my 401k, my 403b, 457, to make sure we understand exactly what sort of benefits are, to make sure that we have at least 6 to 9 months of living expenses in our accounts, to make sure that we understand that we can maximize our taxes or minimize our taxes by putting money to an IRA. All these things, home loans and making sure we're avoiding predatory insurance and not having to use the check cash and the title loans and these scavenger rental center places out here. You know, I get so sick and tired of folks getting mad at them. It's almost like, I'll say, you know, it's like getting mad at a shark for swimming in bloody water. If you cut yourself and jump in the ocean, the shark's gonna come around. This is what they do. We can't get mad at them. I was one of them. We can't get mad at them for long. We can't sit back and keep yelling at Rent-A Center for selling us a $2,000 television for $7,000 with interest. We can't get mad at them because it's a reason why they have these organizations in our communities, because they make money here. They profit here. We don't have to make them profit. If we only use enough love to learn these principles and apply these principles, so we can make sure that instead of them getting the profit, they can go towards our children in 529 plans, to our retirement, so we can retire effectively and not have to work for the golden arches in our golden years. These are the types of things that we can put the check cash in places out of business. Easy. By just researching. Russell Simmons came in here and is racking up shop. Over 2.5 million users on his Rush card. Why is that? Because they've allowed us, they understand that they can capitalize off our ignorance. Now I'm entertained. There's nothing wrong with being ignorant, y'all. I mean, it's a myth. Ignorant is bad. Ignorant is not a bad thing. It is nothing wrong with being ignorant. It's something wrong with staying ignorant. If you stay ignorant, that's where we got to come.
I've overcome a lot of adversity in my life. I've faced physical handicaps. That's why I walk with a limp. I've faced homelessness. I've lost my father, who was the fabric of my family's existence. And I've overcome so much. And I couldn't have done it without Ryan Mack. And I couldn't have done it without, you know, the principles of financial freedom. But one thing about Ryan Mack, aside from all of his knowledge, that makes him so great is his heart. Because as I mentioned, I battled a lot of challenges. And at one point, I had to climb a few stairs to get on stage and impart some knowledge. However, there wasn't any railing on this staircase. So I said, Ryan, I can't climb that high without a railing. Ryan grabbed me by the arm and said, I'll be your rail. And ever since then, this man has helped me climb new heights. And we continue to climb heights together. And I am proud to be part of this organization. I am proud to have become part of the change that I would like to see in my community. And I'm grateful for Ryan Mack, and I'm grateful for you all. Thank you.
It's been a long
time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. I go to the movie and I go downtown. Somebody keep telling me don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother. Say, brother, help me, please.